on which of the following lines lies the point of intersection of the lines here? X minus 4 divided by 2 is equal to y minus 5 by 2 is equal to z minus 3 divided by 1, and the planar x plus y plus z equal to square. Means this is the plane here. Its equation here, x plus y plus z equal to 1, and this is the line here. This line intersect a plane at the point P here. Okay, so therefore this point lies on the line here. So four options are there. So which one the line passing through this point here? Okay, so therefore take your solution here. Let us consider the given line here, x minus 4 divided by 2 is equal to y minus 5 divided by 2 is equal to z minus 3 divided by 1 is equal to some constant r here. Therefore, any point lies on the line is of the form. Is of the form 2 into r becomes 2r. Take a minus for right hand side, it becomes a plus 4 here. 2 into r gives a 2r. Take a minus 5 right hand side, it becomes a plus 5. 1 into r becomes a r. Take a minus 3 right hand side, it becomes a plus 3. Okay. Let us consider. So this is a p point to p itself here. Okay. This point line on the line x plus y plus z is equal to 2 here. Take this part as a p here. Okay. Therefore, I put x value 2r plus 4 here. 2r plus 4, 2r plus 5, 2r plus 5, and plus r plus 3. That is equal to 2 here. Then the 2r plus 2r, 4 plus 1, 5. So it is a 5 r here. Then the 4 plus 5, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. Take a 12 right hand side here. It gives a 2 minus 2 is a minus of 10 here. Yes, the value of r is a minus of 2. Put r value here. Therefore, p is equal to. So 2 into minus 2 plus 4. Then 2 into minus 2 here. 2 into minus 2 plus 5. Minus 2 plus 3. Therefore, 2 2s are 4. Minus 4 plus 4 becomes a 0. 2 2s are 4. 5 minus 4 gives 1. 3 minus 2 gives 1 here. Okay. Just check 1 by 1 here. Here substitute here, x value is 0, minus 4 by 1, and I put y value 1 here, so 1 minus 5 divided by 1, then this equal to z value 1 here, so 1 minus 5 divided by minus 1 here, therefore in this case it is not equal here, therefore first option is wrong here. Again put x value 0. So 3 divided by 3 and y value 1 here, 4 minus 3, 4 minus 1 is a 3, 3 divided by 3, put the z value 1 here, 2 and 2 here, 2 divided by minus 2, so not equal here. Second option is also wrong here. So put x value 0 here, hence minus 2 divided by 2 and y value 1 here, so again it is minus 2 divided by 2. And z value 1, 3 plus 1 becomes 4 divided by 3, not equal here. So third option is wrong here. Next, take care. Put x value 0. So minus 1 divided by 1. Then minus of 2 divided by 2 here. Then 5 by 4. 5 by minus 5. So the ratios are equal here. Therefore, this part lies on the third line here. Therefore, fourth option is correct here. Okay. So this point. Lies on x minus 1 divided by 1 is equal to y minus 3 divided by 2 is equal to z plus 4 divided by minus 5. The part lies on this like this. Fourth option is correct here. The plane which bisects the line segment joining the points are -3, -3, -4 and 3, 7, 6 at right angles passing through which one of the following points here. So there is our plane here. This bisects the line segment AB and it is perpendicular. The line AB is perpendicular to this plane here. Then find the equation of the plane here and which part lies on this plane. Yes. Okay. First, to find the equation of the plane. So, for here P is the midpoint of AB. Because the plane bisects AB means P is the midpoint of AB. First, to find here P using midpoint formula. And also find its direction ratio of the AB. Because here AB itself is normal to this plane. AB itself is normal to the plane. So, find its direction ratio also. Then we can find the equation of the plane here passing through this point having the direction ratio normal to the plane here. Therefore, in this case, let us consider A into vector -3, -3, -4 and B into vector 3, 7, 6 be the given points here. Be the given point. Let P be the midpoint of AB. Midpoint of the line segment AB. Therefore, use the midpoint formula -3 + 3 divided by 2 -3 + 7 here divided by 2. And 4 + 6 divided by 2. 3 - 3 becomes 0. 7 - 3 becomes 4 upon 2 gives 2 here. 6 + 4 = 10 upon 2 becomes 5. It is the coordinate of the point up here. 0, 2, 5. 0, 2 and 5. Then the direction ratio of the line AB. Direction ratio of AB. Or so 3 - -3 so 3 - -3 7 - -3 7 - -3 then 6 - 4 so 6 - 4 here that is so 3 + 3 becomes 6 here 7 + 3 becomes 10 and 6 - 4 becomes 12. Therefore equation of the plane. Equation of the plane passing through the point of here for the coordinates are 0, 2, 5 and normal to the plane direction ratio of normal to the plane. Direction ratios of normal to the plane. So 6, 10, 2. So 6, 10 is therefore 6 × x - 0. Then +10 into negative. So y - 2. Then here 2 × (+2) (z - 5) that is equal to 0. Okay, you are using the formula a (x - x1) + b (y - y1) + c (z - z1) is equal to 0. You are using this formula. Now you simplify. 6 × x becomes 6x, 10 × y becomes 10y, 10 × 2 = 20, -20, +2z minus of 10 is equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, 6x here plus 10y plus 2z and minus of 30 is equal to 0. Dividing both the sides by 2 here. So, 3x plus 5y plus z minus of 15 equal to 0. It is the equation of the plane here. Now we go on substitute the parts here. So 3 poles are 12 here. Then minus of 5. Then 7 here. Plus 7. Minus of 15 here. So it cannot be 0. Means this part not placed on the plane. Take the second part here. 3 toes are 6. Then 5 ones are 5. Plus 5. Then 3 here. Plus 3. Minus of 15 again. This is not equal to 0. Next, take this one here. 3 2s are 6. Minus 6. 3 5s are 15. Sorry, 3 5s are 15. Minus of 15 here. Then plus 5. And minus of 15 here. Again, this is not equal to 0. Take this one here. So, 3 4s are 12 here. Then 5 2 and 5. Then minus 2 here. So, it is minus of 2. Minus 15. Therefore, this is equal to 0. Therefore, this part lies on the plane here. So, fourth option is cut here. Therefore, 4, 1, comma, minus 2 lies on the plane here. So, fourth option is correct here.